Well, what are you going to do about Chris?
If the case goes against her, Larry will handle the appeal.
No, I mean if they free her.
I don't know. Paula, I trusted her and still can't understand her. You never liked her, did you?
I detested her. Maybe it was a slight attack of bad conscience. She seemed a little wholesome for my taste. But if you came up here because you thought I was going to say something nasty about her, you're out of luck. Oh, I know. You're afraid you've been a little hard on her, and you want someone to tell you how mean she was to you. Oh, skip it. I'm not going to blast you tonight.
Go ahead. It's better than all that silent sympathy I'm getting from everybody else.
All right, then. Sure, I'm sorry for you. But I'm sorry for her, too. I went to see her, and believe me, that jail is no place to spend Thanksgiving.
Yeah, that's kind of rough.
She's not complaining. Faring up very well. She's worried about you. Doesn't think you look so well. She really loves you, Bob.
She should have thought of that before.
2.5 years is a long time.
I managed it.
In the South Pacific. Try it on Wilshire Boulevard.
Is it my fault I was sent overseas?
Listen, you knew you were going when you met her. Let's face it, that's why you married her.
I married her because I loved her.
Sure, for 2 whole weeks. How long was that supposed to last her? What you wanted was a whirl and a memory. You wanted a beautiful woman waiting for you. And you didn't want anyone making time with her while you were away, so you hung up a no trespassing sign, like you'd stake a gold claim. You didn't marry her, you just took an option on her.
She could have said no.
While the band was playing? Listen, I was there. I saw you making with that uniform and that today we live routine, and then you were off.
Oh, Paula.
Do you think a woman can make a career out of looking at a picture? She needs more than a wedding ring and a letter a week to hang on to. And when you came back, did you give her a chance to explain? Did it ever occur to you that she'd been under a strain, too, and she might not have been strong enough to stand up under it? You've always been proud, Bob. Too proud to admit that your wife could be anything but perfect.
What do I suppose to be?
A human being, and that's 2 strikes against anybody. No, I'm not condoning what she did. It was wrong and it was awful. But do you think you couldn't trust her now? Or is it still your manly pride?
A man can't throw his pride out the window.
He can try. I've made half the mistakes in the book. I spoiled my marriage because I thought it was something you'd tried out, like new drapes for the living room. If it didn't work out quite right, you did it over in the spring. But Chris isn't like that. If you give her half a chance, she'll be as good a wife as any man could want.
I'm sorry, I'm not the forgiving type.
No one thinks he is. The moral aspects of the case don't stop you loving her, do they?
I'll get over that.
Sure. And how long will it take you to find a girl who'll make you as happy as she did?